It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
I'd like to welcome to our West Coast studios from the North Pole, Santa and his elves. Santa, we know who you are, so I'd like to have the elves introduce themselves for the audience.
I'm Trixie Elf.
Hi, Trixie.
Louie, the head elf. I've been here since day one, 2017 years. I know everything that's going on.
I'm his friend.
Well, thanks for coming in tonight, guys.
Seems to be the issue.
Santa, let's start off by asking about Mrs. Santa. How's your wife doing?
Mrs. Santa's doing great. She keeps me coffeeed up, full of energy, because I got to be on those elves' back all the time to make sure they get done.
She's
by
got
the
great
end of the
hair.
Year.
She's got great hair.
Santa, I'm sure the biggest question for the listeners, young and old alike, is are you on track this year? Is everything on time? Will Christmas happen?
Tell him, Santa. Yes. Tell him you're on track, Santa.
Christmas will happen. All the kids will get their toys on time this year. If I have to whip these elves the last day, because they're slacking a little bit, but we're really close.
Santa, I love Coco.
Wow. Taskmaster.
Trixie, watch it. But trust me, after the Christmas holiday is over, these elves are going to learn their lesson about falling behind.
Santa's got a nice belt buckle. It's very big.
Santa, I know it's probably Santa client privilege, but what the hell? I'll take a shot. Who was the naughtiest this year? And if you could say what they were into, what was so bad?
Was it me, Santa? Was it Trixie?
Dude, that was so bad.
Say me, Santa.
Yeah, Trixie.
Yeah, it was Trixie. She's the troublemaker of the group. She's always hiding under the table, and I thought she was just hiding, but there's some rumors going around that we got to check into.
I like candy canes.
Wow.
I like
she's
coal.
She's always trouble. See, she can't even keep her mouth shut.
That's what he says.
And she's just a little pepper ball that never knows when to give it up.
Is that rumor, or do they really just get a lump of coal?
They do get a lump of coal, especially Trixie, because that's all
lump.
She seems to handle. She likes
same lump I got last year, Santa.
I'd like to address a few questions to our elven guests tonight. How in the world do you guys do it? I mean, that is a lot of damn toys. How do you do that?
A lot of work. We're very organized. We just don't have the proper tools. He goes to Home Depot, gets us tools that are too big for our hands.
Calm down, Hiddo. Calm down. I have some cocoa.
How can we make computers and video games and
Namaste.
All that
Namaste.
With these tools
calm down.
Don't even work? And then the ones I have a hammer that's over 2,000 years old.
Just use what you have. It's not about the tools you got. It's about the process. The hard work you need to put into it. Otherwise, it just means nothing.
Process. We work our fingers to the bone.
That's why everyone likes Trixie. She puts her back into it.
Yes, I'll bet she does. Not to be too nosy, but I always wondered if elves date in the off-season. Do you guys have separate male-female quarters?
Yes, we date a lot. And no. No, we all live together in one big happy dorm.
Well, that's going to change soon.
That's why we're going on strike. We want more candy cakes. More chocolate breaks, better elf benefits.
You know, that leads me into my next question. When I was researching for this interview, I ran across some posts about a so-called labor dispute or some issue between you elves and Santa.
Yeah,
is there any truth to that rumor?
Yes, and it starts with the top. We need to know who's in charge, either him or Miss Claus.
Working for Coco. I like it.
He knows who's in charge. Santa's always in charge.
You can't.
If they keep this up, I'm going overseas and get me some cheap labor. These elves
that's
are just
right. And
too
you're
much
gonna get
trouble.
Cheap toys.
Chinese elves.
They're out there. I've seen them. Yes.
Okay. Well, that's about all the time I think we have for our interview tonight. I'd like to thank Santa
elves forever
and his elves for coming to the studio today.
Elves forever.
Merry Christmas to all.
Get back to work before I take that 70-inch TV out of here.
Let you have a safe and happy Christmas from Crim Radio. Good night, everyone.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas.